Hi, everybody. Welcome back. It's November 24th, 2022. It's Thanksgiving Day. Yay! I'm getting ready to watch the Macy's Day Parade. I watch that every year. It's really entertaining when it's windy, too. So we're going back to Rubin Ridge, and we've been here before, probably several times. And in fact, I even made a short video, a video series on this area. I had 8 videos, and I divided up this picture into 8 pieces. And, you know, the series really wasn't that good. It's pretty crude from about 3-4 years ago. I've come a long way since then. There were some good pictures, but mostly it was pretty crude. When this picture first popped up, I got it from the Photojournal, the NASA Photojournal. And when you first see the picture, when it first comes up, it's very, very small. It just looks like something sort of typical. And right here on the page, it says the erosion effects on Vera Rubin Ridge, full resolution. Cracks me up when they put full resolution on. It's always nothing, anything but full resolution. This picture, or this photo journal, they did have a something for you to read here, and I don't know. I was torn between letting you read it or read it out loud. I'm going to go ahead and read it out loud. This view of Vera Rubin Ridge from the chemistry and camera. Okay, it's a pretty bad start to begin with, isn't it? Okay, I'll tell you what. I'll let you read it. Just read the part that's in the yellow. Shouldn't take you very long. I can hear the music from that game show. What is it? Anyway, it doesn't matter. It's all been removed. Okay. They talked about the erosion effects and what it was that you find sticking up up in the reaching towards the sky towards the top up there. It's just supposed to be some sort of rock that's resistant to wind erosion, and it just created these spires that go up there, and that's what it's supposed to be. And of course, and naturally, they didn't expect anybody to look closely. But I'll tell you what, looking closely at this picture is really astounding. It clearly shows ongoing life, right? Civilization. No matter how you might want to resist that notion, it's real and it's happening here. And there have been some new revelations for me. You know, when I first started looking and making videos about this place years ago, there were a lot of things I didn't understand yet. So these things have become clear. Now, in the past, when I looked at this area here, particularly this gap, this right here, this to me looked like a new construction, that they were constructing it. There was a hollow area there for whatever reason. But knowing what I know now, that everything that the Curiosity rover took pictures of was downed vessels, okay? We've gone through this many, many times, and through the buttes, all of the buttes, and that's what it is. You know, if you haven't watched this channel before, you'd probably be really confused. But these buttes that are in these the butte videos clearly show the remains of vessels of all different kinds, big and small, and the same is true here. But the one thing that's different about Vera Rubin Ridge compared to the other buttes that we saw, that we've seen, is that here they seem to be constructing new structures on top of the old crashed vessels. So, you know, we have not seen that before. We've seen other areas on Mars that clearly show life, but none of them show construction, new construction, on top of old, crashed junk. I don't know what to call it. It covers the whole area. So we have everything in this video, from the very interesting things on the very top to clusters of very clear clusters of buildings. Really, the whole entire area is covered with buildings of one kind or another. In this area here, off to the left from what was going up on top, we see kind of three areas here on the right, these clusters of very clear buildings, and then this area here to the left. And I developed this a little bit differently. You can tell by a sort of a pasty look, but it makes it more able for us to see these pictures, to see these buildings, I mean. Sometimes you have to get creative to try and bring things out. But these buildings are in rows, and they lead out to these points. And there's this one point closest to us that really leans out over the, in the air, out over the whatever's below. I don't know what that would be, but yeah, it's this is the fancy condo here. You got to be pretty special to live in this condo that leans out over the open space and is the place where, I guess, if you're rich, you know, I don't know if that's what it would take, but accidentally made that picture go away too quickly, doggone it. That happens once in a while. So, yeah, nothing subtle about these pictures, actually. And like I said, it could be divided up into eight different sections. There's so much to look at, and I didn't really break it down that way this time, but I did focus on certain things. And right in front there is something in the past that I called, it looked like a, what do they call those outdoor entertainment areas? Anyway, it's a piece of vessel. We'll see that picture again, I think. Now, right in front here is this big white area, and this is what NASA was calling the layers of eroding layers. And there's nothing eroding here. These layers are not natural, and this is a built-up area. And I think this is from scratch. I do not believe that they're building on top of any old down vessels at all. And in this area, it's this area from bottom of the screen moving up is slanted, and it's actually like a staircase. So that white area right in the middle, the bright white area, is the highest part of that white area. I don't know, am I making any sense at all? This would be a great time to have a pointer, you know. But the bottom of the screen is the lowest, and the reaches up to the middle part of this screen right here, and it's like a stair step, and we'll see some pictures that make that a little bit more clear for us. There's this one area right here. It looks like an area that is not filled in yet, that they are still working on. And then at the other end of this white area here is some real interesting stuff here. You very clearly see the structures and the way this is all put together. And if there ever was anything alien, this is it. I mean, this whole video, this whole place could not be more alien. With the stuff that we have on top, and well, really everything here, it's so unique, and it's all very clear. and very obvious, and it's so unlike anything that that we've even considered here on Earth. You know, here we have this layered construction that's made out of buildings, and they end up putting buildings on top of buildings. All right, this is just something that wouldn't happen here. It's a so different from anything that we would even consider, actually. And in this picture, you can see in the background there, this very square construction with buildings. And on top of this layered construction, you can also see a pretty large, towards the center of the screen, white building on top with some dark buildings behind it. So, yeah, this is a truly alien place. Now, here is a crane, folks, and there's two cranes in this image. This one's down on the ground, and it's plopping a building into place. Can you see the little rows of buildings? This is dead center on the screen. And there's once they drop that structure into place, there's one laying on the ground there that they're going to pick up and drop it into place as well. This was a really unique picture, really in large part because of that crane, because you can see it in action, that it's in the process of dropping a building into place. This is a better view of that square construction in the back, and once again you can see the buildings in front on top of this layered construction. Pretty big building there. All of those, the white building and the black ones behind it, they're all pretty darn large compared to all the other places here. Now, if you look closely and perceive that the bottom of this picture is the bottom and it goes up as you go towards the top of it, you can perceive these stair step construction here. And actually, I think I have one or two more pictures that will zero in on that a little bit. And I've never been able to figure out, dead center, we have the crane there, what that thing is next to it. It's this oddly shaped dark mass, and I've never been able to get clarity on it, and I just don't know what the heck that is. And if you look at the sloping area coming down towards the bottom, you see towards the bottom there's a one large building there. It's a cylindrical building down towards the bottom of that slope. It stands out above, over and above the other buildings in the area. See that? Can you see that stair step, how it slopes up there? Now, this is not, there's nothing natural about this. There are no rocks in this picture. And that area in the back is so interesting with the very square, cube-shaped buildings back there. And off to the right, over here, is a structure that's all kind of off on its own over there. I don't know if it's a piece of debris or if it's something that's a fresh construction. It does have that shape of that layering that we see that over that what we've seen over on the left of this. So hard to say. Yep, and right down here is this area that's not filled in yet. There is a band of light that comes down right through the middle of this area that kind of messes up the picture a little bit. I don't know if you can see it. It's right in the center of the screen, and it comes down at a little bit of an angle. And unfortunately, it comes right over the top of that that large building there, which made it more difficult to clear up and to be able to see. But the fact that it's so large makes it pretty easy to see. And you can see all of these rectangular dark gaps in the structure back in the back area Obviously, this is not rocks. Very, you know, one of the things that people always ask me, well, I hear frequently, I should say, is what are we looking at? And, you know, that question in particular comes up more often when we're looking at satellite images, because, you know, that takes that does take a little bit of understanding, a little more understanding to know what you're looking at. But whether it's the satellite images or whether it's these rover pictures, and if we're talking about civilization, we're looking for structures. And structures typically come in the form of, you know, rectangular shapes or square shapes. Bottom line is they have right angles. And this is what we're looking for whenever we're trying to determine if there is civilization there. And that's one of the things that we have to see, the structural geometry that makes up, you know, civilization. Now, right in the center of the screen, you see a white thing coming across the top with a bunch of buildings on it. Now, this is something that I saw that I didn't see in the past, that I know now is another vessel that has come down on top of everything else. And you can see how it's, you know, following the contours. It's we can say it's broken its keel, shall we say. Very clearly a vessel there that has buildings built up on it. So this is something that, you know, I just didn't notice before. You know, it was just there, I guess. And, you know, this is true. I've gone back and looked at many of my old pictures and see things that that I didn't see, that I overlooked. So over time, you begin to realize what it is you're looking at. Now, right all the way up at the top here, we have these beautiful buildings with some real unique design features. One is cylindrical, and the other to the left of the cylindrical building, right in the middle, is sort of a mushroom-shaped building. And then all the way up at the top right are a bunch of other buildings with that I think are cylindrical. But here is that vessel that came down, that's kind of bent up there, and they're building on top of now. And this is the very top of the very Rubin Ridge picture. And these were some things that previously I couldn't really clear up that well. A lot of buildings up there. Everything isn't that the way it always is. It's always buildings, buildings, buildings. Now look at the very top of this picture. On the left and the right, you can see the very dark buildings mixed in with light-colored buildings. See them all? There's a lot there. And then all of the buildings in this mass right in front of us. And I don't know what the gaps are, you know, the sandy looking areas. I have no idea. Maybe it's just sand, you know, I don't know. But I can tell you, if this were image artifacts, that sandy area would be filled full of these buildings as well. So obviously this is not image artifacts. And one of the other things, I hope we get another picture of this area right here. So this black area right in front of us here is sort of triangular shaped. And it's actually a broken off piece from a very large triangular vessel. I hope I have another picture to show that to you. Yeah. And this gap, I mean, for the longest time I thought, wow, that's a construction, and why do they need this big hollow area here? But, you know, look at what's on top. Now, you see that there's two things up there. There's actually three things, but two things in particular sticking up. And one of those things is a crane, and the item on the right, and it's holding something that it's circular that's dangling over the edge up there. You see that? And then there's the thing that's shaped like a cross, and behind that is a very dark, what looks like a vessel to me of some kind. Yeah. It's a beautiful area. Wouldn't I love to see this picture in color? This was taken by the ChemCam, which is probably the only bit of truth that they mentioned in the NASA Photojournal. And I can't recall if I mentioned to you that this picture is no longer available. I think I made too many videos on it, and they took it down. So it's a goner. I'm sorry, you know, I was warned about that a long time ago by Technothanks Physical Astronomy, that he had put up pictures that later disappeared off of the archive out of the Photojournal. And I just didn't think that enough people were watching my videos, and that I had to worry about that, so I just kept putting them out. But yes, a lot of pictures have disappeared, and I'm sorry to say, I'm thinking that it's me to blame for it. I know there's at least 15 pictures that have either been removed or heavily altered, unfortunately. And one of the biggest losses of all is this picture right here. Vera Rubin Ridge. You know, they said that they took this picture from 143 feet away. Not 150 or 160, but 143. I guess that makes it more believable. However, there's no way in hell that picture was taken from 143 feet. It had to be more like a quarter mile or more, because you would not be able to get all of this in from 143 feet. So that's another one of the ways that NASA uses to obfuscate what we're looking at. They use coloration. They use distance or scale. They blur the pictures. There's so many things they do. They have a lot of arrows in that quiver. And for sure, scale is one of the biggest ones of all. So I don't believe their little scale device that tells you how big things are. Don't believe it. Anyway, thanks for watching, everyone. I hope you enjoyed the video.